This DNews episode is brought to you by domain.com. The measles, the mumps, and rubella are things that you hear about in the news all the time, but what are they? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. You follow the news, right? So I probably don't need to tell you that there has been an outbreak of the measles linked to a certain mouse-centered park system. I don't know about you, but when I hear outbreak of measles, I start thinking back to like the 17th century, colonial America. But since the virus was identified in the 19-teens and a vaccination was created in the late 50s, the measles has been a relatively easy disease to control in the US. In fact, our regional strain of the measles was eliminated from the US as of 2000. It's called an endemic strain, but it's still fairly common in Europe, Asia, Africa, and in the Pacific. In 2014, though, there were a record number of measles cases in the US. The CDC says there were 644 cases in 27 states last year alone, and a majority of the people who were infected were unvaccinated. Makes sense? Herd immunity can only protect you for so long, people. 2015 already has had 59 cases of the measles from a single Disneyland exposure, including 5 employees of the parks. The measles is really contagious, y'all. It was first described by Persian physicians in the year 900, and it causes a rash all over your body, swelling, fever, a cough, and little spots inside of your cheeks called Koplik spots. It's deadly to young children and is one of the leading causes of death for children worldwide. Measles, or rubeola, is a virus, so there's no cure. It spreads by flying into the air during a cough or sneeze, or by piggybacking on the sharing of food or drinks. If you had the measles and you are watching this, congratulations! Tell us about the history, Nana and Pop Pop, because most people born before 1957 have had the measles. So, you know, I just want to make you guys feel included. The reason the cutoff is 1957 is because in 1958, a vaccine went into wide use and boom, measles infections dropped precipitously. Since then, the WHO has attempted to vaccinate children worldwide, which likely has saved hundreds of thousands of lives. Since the year 2000, they have dropped cases 75% worldwide, thanks to the MMR vaccine. The vaccine for the measles is part of this MMR vaccine, which stands for measles, mumps, and rubella. Measles is the worst, but the mumps causes a swelling of the parotid glands, giving the face kind of a hamster look, which sounds cute, but it's not cute. It's painful and it is highly contagious. It can also cause inflammation of the testes, ovary, pancreas, or meninges. Rubella is also known as the German measles, and it's kind of like the measles, but kind of milder. Luckily for us, the MMR vaccine is one of the most effective in the world. With only 2 doses, 97% of human immune systems create enough antibodies to fight off the measles virus. Usually, the first comes near birth, and the second a few years later to make sure that immunity is solid. It's called a booster. Measles do obviously sound crappy, what with the rashes and diarrhea, but it can also cause permanent damage to the lungs or the brain and is connected to seizures and meningitis, so it's no laughing matter. This strange resurgence of measles that we're hearing about in the news is likely because of the recent trend against vaccination. According to Wired and the CDC, only 6 of the infected had the MMR shot and the rest did not, which jives with that high protection rate. If people stop getting the MMR vaccine, they become happy little dumpsters for the diseases which can't take hold anywhere else. As we only eliminated the endemic measles, or the ones here in the US, unvaccinated Americans traveling abroad are still able to contract measles where it has not been eliminated and transport it to new areas before they even show symptoms. Even perfect immunity isn't entirely safe. Remember, it's only 97% effective. So this is where personal choices for vaccination can become problematic. It might be a personal choice to be an anti-vaxxer, but this choice can actually harm other people. In this case, even those who did get vaccinated. Have you ever had the measles though? You can tell us down in the comments. You can also subscribe for more DNews and check out this video on how flu vaccines are even made. It's pretty awesome. And the guy who does the videos, he's pretty nice. Thanks for watching.